perfect body, perfect legs. Cosmetic addiction, modification. The woman of a thousand faces. Let's get invasive, let's get real messed up.
Wow, that's wild. Hey everyone, how's it going? How are we on this Monday night? Put this at zero. Lower that down a little more. I'm a little annoyed because my computer cart, sort of the wheel on it, broke. And I'm very unhappy about that. But I'm here. And we've got cards to open, as I now have to buy a new computer cart to put this thing on and throw this one out. So this piece of shit right here, this Razer Kiyo, didn't want to work being plugged into the front of the computer at all, for literally no reason. There's nothing else plugged in the front of the computer. I have the same amount of stuff plugged in as any other time that I've done streams like this. It just decided it didn't want to work unless it was plugged in one specific spot in the back of the computer. So it's, you know, we're here. We're going to get into it immediately because I've lost a lot of my drive. I just got really fucking pissed off really quickly. Really, really took a lot of the wind out of my fucking sails. Genuinely made me very angry. Anyway. Here we are. So there's a card store by my job. So I got Maze of Millennia. I got AGOV. All my fucking fellas. I don't have that setting put on my little thing now. I'm not on my Lethal Company setting. We're gonna open Maze of Millennia first. because I care the least about this one. Like, Bonfire is cool, and if I could get triple tactics thrust, that'd be great. But I've heard that it's not been in a lot of these. I heard that it's like kind of a short print ultra rare, which makes me angry. Because why would you reprint a card to make it fucking short print, you psychopaths? Konami makes me fucking angry. But there's also all the cool new Flame Swordsman support and stuff, new illusions, the Bonfire. Which I honestly, if I get a Bonfire or two, I will just sell them. Sell them like 60 each instead of 80. Thrust a super short print, buy more boxes, that's why. It's cool. It's a really, really great thing for them to do. And then we're going to do Agov after, because I need Little Knight. I need Diabelle Star. I need the spell card. The best thing that this could give me is either Diabelle Star, Little Knight, or the wanted spell card. The best possible scenario is pulling all of those, which is next to impossible, but not like there's a non-zero chance, but it is next to impossible. But if I even just get a Little Knight or a wanted, then this is worth it. So that's how I'm looking at it. We're gonna open this motherfucker up. I don't know if you could hear that.
This sucks.
I agree. Don't forget to listen to Face Jam. Hold on, I gotta do the Face Jam thing. Hold on. Face Jam. I forgot I still had that command. Oh wait, I still have the fucking little button, don't I?
Face Jam, the Fortnite podcast. Every 2 weeks on Tuesday at 3 a.m.
Face Jam, Face Jam, Face Jam, Face Jam.
At 3 a.m.
Face Jam, Face Jam, Face Jam, Face Jam.
Anyway. Pray for the good pulls. Pray for the good pulls. I'm gonna have this free Riot Games Music Creator Safe Collection playing in the background. By the way, fuck all those layoffs that happened at Riot. That's very, very unfortunate. It sucks a lot, but what can you do? How can I get into this without destroying the box? There we go. Slip it right in. Look for Snake Eye Ashes, they're solid supers. Oh, that'd be great also. And like, if I manage to get some of the good enough Flame Swordsman, I've heard that the new Flame Swordsman stuff's actually like pretty good. Yeah, I got it working. I had to plug it into one specific spot in the back of the computer. You gotta flip it up for authenticity's sake. There we go.
Come and get your cards, children's.
Let's open this bitch up. I broke out of the habit. I used to open these up perfectly to preserve one of them to keep. I've been doing that since Pharaoh's Servant, on and off, since I've been in and out of the game. And I recently threw out all of those because I was like, there's no need for me to do this. There is no need at all for me to fucking do this. It's a waste. It takes up too much space. It sucks. Now I gotta have all these. All right, what do we got here? Spring King Dragon Dark Worm. Gotta find the best angle to show these off. Flame Swords Dance. I don't know what the fuck this does. A lot of fucking text. If a monster is special summon a level 7 or lower fusion monster from your extra deck that is Flame Swords or mentions it, then change a face-up monster on the field to face-down defense position. Your opponent's battle phase, banish this card from your graveyard, tribute one face down, defense position monster, special summon a Flame Swordsman, or any one monster that mentions it from your deck or extra deck. It's okay. That's all right. Chlorless! Dark World Mansion! I actually am very happy to have that. I like Chlorless, even though it's dog water. That's cool. Extinguish! Sure. Magic Scepter Cyclone. Rescue! Earthbound Servant and Geo Gremlin. Those things are scary. I don't like them. I also, when I was at MAG, I got some, ow, fuck. I got some Dragon Shield sleeves. And I, oh, thirsty little flower. I realized that I'm an idiot. Because this whole time I've been using sleeves, like, I have this one here. I don't know why I'm not doing that. Like this one, where it just doesn't fit the card fully like that. And I actually have my super heavy cards in here. And these are the Japanese fit, so they just like fit it uniform and much more nicely. Can I show up and eat the most expensive card you pull? I will literally stab you in the throat. Maybe from this pack. I don't know if I'll give enough of a shit if it's from this pack. Yeah, I've been buying standard sleeves, which are still useful because I bought physical Digimon TCG cards and I have a bunch of Pokemon cards that I can sleeve. So like they're, I can still use them. It's not like it's a waste. But now I just gotta get smaller ones for the Yu-Gi-Oh cards. I should also get rid of a lot of the fucking stock that I have, because I have way too much, way too many cards. Yeah, bro, fucking flip it or rip it. Earthbound Prisoner, Line Walker. These guys are cool. Jet Synchron. I'm going to set you aside because I want you. I don't know if I have Jet Synchrons. Phoenix Gearblade. Only do a warrior or fire monster. Gains 300 attack at the end of the damage step. The equipped monster attacked. You can send this card to the graveyard during this battle phase. Each of your warrior monsters and fire monsters can make second attack. If this card is sent to the graveyard or banished, activate a monster effect. Add this card to your hand. I have to wake up in 6 hours. Well, I'm sorry, Ryan Superfan. I just got home from work like an hour ago, so I'm here doing this. Cool. It's not that I couldn't use them. It's that I have so many now that are going to be replaced that those new ones, I'm like, I can use them. 100 Eyes Dragon. King Gate Infinity Code Hacks Altergeist Multifaker. Multifaker's kind of cool. I don't know shit about Altergeists. I just know that Altergeist Multifaker is kind of neat as a card. I'll just drink a lot of coffee. I feel that. I think it's really funny that Konami thinks equip spells are obligated to give an attack boost. So they're like, if this equip spell gives 200 attack, you could attribute it to a million things. Oh yeah, Konami's very funny with what they print and stuff. Contain Doppel Warrior, that's actually good to get. Supreme King Dragon Dark Rebellion. I don't even know if this is like the good one. Satellite Synchron. Fighting Flame Swordsman. What does this guy do? This card is normal, special summoned. Add a spell trap that mentions Flame Swordsman from your deck to your hand. Send to the graveyard to send one Flame Swordsman or one monster that mentions it from your deck or extra deck to the graveyard. Except fighting. Only use this effect once per... Each effect once per turn. Oh. Alright, not bad. Alert! Gazelle! They had to reprint Gazelle because this card is always treated as a Phantom Beast card. They had to add the little flavor text. If I max my phone and hold it against the wall, will we get a funny echo? Oh, there's a possibility. Who knows? Yeah, Flame Swordsman is like a real archetype now. I watched MBT's video with Flame Swordsman and Infernoble Knights, and the combos he was doing were actually kind of solid. I want to get into Yu-Gi-Oh so bad, I feel like I'm so far behind. It's not impossible, but it's going to be super difficult. They just put out the two-player starter deck thing, and that's really good for teaching you some of the basics, but it's only really for two of the extra deck summoning mechanics, but it does do a good job of teaching you like the basics. After opening that booster box today, I am hooked on the back end of physical Yu-Gi-Oh! Send help and cards. You can have some of my cards. I'll give you some of them. I have so many. I have so fucking many cards. I need to get rid of so fucking many of them. I pulled Amazing Defenders and realized I have enough for a Labyrinth deck almost. Like, I have almost every card needed for a Labyrinth deck, and I'm like, I mean, I shouldn't. The Legendary Oceans. How many do you want? How many do you want? Say one. Space Jam DVD. Yeah, Mimi, I pulled a lot of Pearly cards also. I'm honestly, like, I'm surprised I didn't pull any of the actual Pearly. I pulled almost every Pearly card except for Pearly itself. Jet Synchron, God Kraken, Dragon Clearwing, Reinforce, Drastic Draw. Banish all monsters you control, minimum 2. Draw 3 cards. Cannot normal special summon the turn you activate this card. Except Cybris monsters. Only activate 1 per turn. So you need to have at least 2 monsters on the field for that to draw 3. I guess that's kind of fine in like Salamangreat maybe, because you just summon all the time. That could be okay for that, maybe. Yeah, it's not great, but can I get a signed Legendary Ocean? You know what? I probably should just do that. I probably should just sign Legendary Oceans and send them out. I don't know how much the other Pearlies go for, but I mean, hey, maybe if you want more of the Pearly cards, I can just give you the ones I have, even though they're a little bent, because Yu-Gi-Oh cards bend like fucking crazy. Mirage Swordsman. If a face up fire, oh, this is so much text. Fire Fusion monster you control is destroyed by battle of card effect. You can special summon this card from your graveyard if it was there when the monster was destroyed or hand, even if not. What? I've never seen "even if not" on a card ever in my life. At the start of the damage step, this card battles an opponent's monster, destroy both battling monsters. If this card is destroyed by battle or another card's effect, special summon a level 7 or lower monster that is Flame Swordsman or mentions it from your deck or extra deck. Each effect once per turn. That's not terrible. I'm holding it a little too close. There we go. I was trying to read it. That's not bad. These are sometimes some cards that can summon themselves from the graveyard. A new Fire King Savage? That's insane. Desynchro, sure. Ultimate Flame Swordsman. That's a cool one. Flame Swordsman fighting. Okay, it's actually a person. I get scared for a second. Why did I just get DM'd this? I was just. Is this not going to drop in? Oh no. Drop into there. Oh no. Hold on. I was just sent this on Discord. Thank you, Addy. Sick. You can target one monster. Hold on, I'm gonna respond to that one. I just said pretty epic. Oh. That image is awesome. I knocked the shit out of this webcam. Alright, target one monster your opponent controls, destroy it, and if you do, inflict 500 damage to your opponent. This is a quick effect. This card is equipped with an equipped card. Alright, start a damage step, battles, double this card's attack until the end of this turn. And if you do, destroy it during the end phase this turn. Alright, so I can see how that can work with Infernobles. Supreme Rage, Magic Scepter Cyclone again, Altergeist Hextia, Perfumet Reprint, Lord Cressy. Fucking sucks ass. Sucks pee pee caca. You see the Flame Princess is an Ultra? Oh, Promethean? Yeah. She's gonna cost me a lot of money and I'm gonna be upset. But she's not out until February, so I mean, that bitch is gonna be a fucking almost $200 card, I can guarantee it. She's gonna be crazy in this format. And if not, then I'll be happy, because then that means I can buy her for my solid deck for a cheap price. Dragon Darkworm. Horned Saurus. I forgot about this fucking thing. This card can attack directly, turn it a special summon. It can only use its effect once per turn. If this card is future summon, take a field spell from your deck or graveyard face up in your field zone. During your main phase, you can immediately after this effect resolves normal summon a dinosaur or dragon. Alright. I mean, that's alright. Armored Exceed. It's the armor cards! From that one thing! Whoa! But if it's a monster you control and exceed monster in your graveyard, equip that monster from your graveyard to that monster in the field as an equip spell with these effects. Change the equipped monster's attack to this card's attack. Equip monster gains this card's attribute. At the end of the damage step, if the equipped monster attacked, you can send this card to the graveyard. The attacking monster can make a second attack in a row. Oh, fucking okay. Jesus Christ. That's kind of wild. Full Armored Crystal Zero Lancer. Sun God Unification. Is this... They put fucking Ring Dragon and Raw Support in this bitch? What the fuck? I've never seen this in my life. That's insane. Gate Zero, Full Armored Black Ray. They're cool. Put his fire on the art, put it in the set. Yeah, that's what it seems like. Let's crack this bitch. Let me respond to Adele over here. Doppel Warrior. Desynchro. The Fiend. How bad is this one? Discard this card, add a light barrier from your deck or graveyard to your hand. That's funny. This card is summoned, toss a coin, gains the appropriate effect. Heads, an attack is declared involving this card. Target a monster on the field, destroy it. Inflict 5 more damage to its controller. If an attack is declared involving this card, destroy all monsters on the field. Shit. All right, sure, whatever. Sun God, extinguish! Salamandra Fusion. Equip only to a fire warrior monster. Gain 700 attack. If the equipped monster would be destroyed by battle or card effect, you can destroy this card instead. When this card is equipped to a fusion monster you control, send this card and the equipped monster to the graveyard, and if you do, special summon a flame swordsman or fusion monster that mentions it from your extra deck. You can only use this effect once per turn. That's strange and interesting. Azulapisku. More like Kaka Poo Poo. Hello, it's Hero Burst Dinatrix fans about to be eaten good. Dude, she's pretty fucking nutty right now. It'd be really funny if they put the raw support in the set with Flame Swordsman to be like, remember when Joey lost to Merrick? That'd be funny as shit. Ground Keeper, Mirage Swordsman again. Geo Griffin, Synchro Chase, blah blah blah. A lot of shit we saw already. I'm gonna have to put so many of these fuckers in. I'm gonna have to pull one of those tins out of my garbage can. Slap these fucks in there. Which is actually a good thing. What's your favorite extra deck summoning mechanic? Exceed. I really like Exceed. The second they were introduced, I was like, this is amazing. That's when I think Yu-Gi-Oh got good, and then Pendulum happened. Line Walker. Prime Banshee. I don't know shit about Altergeist. There's Geo Grasha. He's cool. Battle Synchron. Ring Announcer. Battle and Boxers. Extia. Look at this fucking toad! Dude's just fucking chilling. Why are you screaming about whites? Is it because this guy was white? That is a white man. He scared the shit out of me. I don't like him. Yo, Ojama Lime? No. When are they releasing Ojama Lime? Come on. Get it together. Bitch, call me a sorcerer. I'm gonna stab her. in Minecraft. When Rada releases the hero video. Oh. Earthbound Lion Walker. Earthbound Immortals cannot be destroyed by their own effects. It's very funny you had to print a monster that says that. Stupid. Ashoka Pill. I've never seen this in my life. What is this? If this card is summoned, you can add an equipped spell card from your deck to your hand. Then if this card is in attack position, change it to defense. You can only use this effect once per turn. If this card is a battle card effect, take 2,000 out of my fucking face. Salamandra with chain. This one's kind of crazy. Target a fire monster on the field. Equip this card to it as an equipped card that gives it 700 attack. You can change an effective monster on the field to the face down defense. Banish this card from your graveyard. Fusion summon a fire warrior or dragon fusion monster from your extra deck. By shuffling its materials from your hand, field, and or graveyard into the deck, but destroy it during the end phase. That's kind of a crazy card, actually. Cabrera Stone. Add one triangle O from your deck to your hand. If he's in attack position, change it to defense. I guess those are... that's stupid. That's dumb. Seeing 5Ds cards before you guys watch it is funny. I know very little about 5Ds, but what I do know about it is funny. I didn't mean to do all of that. I just meant to move the wire slightly. And it pulled everything. That sucked. It's the Yu-Gi-Oh card sausage. Oh, I've heard the 5Ds this peak, and I know some things, not a lot, but some things about it. Marionetter. Emergency. Oh, shit, that's like my third one. Hell yeah. Turbulence. 100 Ice Dragon. Infinity. Earthbound Release. Chimera. The Flying Mythic. Anyway. I could make Chimera. That's true. I did pull its components. I think I also have some of the new ones that they made. The illusion fuckers. Hello, Mr. Carl. How are you doing today? My throat's hurting a little bit. Where did I put my water? There it is. I literally just thought that the whole bottle vanished. That scared the shit out of me. We're Gucci. Oh, of course I'm stuck in too much take. You know what? Flame Swords Dance. Marionetter. Kaidoptera. Now I can make that fucking fusion we got earlier. Opponent controls two or more face-up monsters, except the wind monsters. Those monsters cannot target this card for attacks. You can only use the effect of each of the following effects once per turn. During main phase, add a polymerization from your deck to your hand. This card's banished. Special summon it, then add a poly from your graveyard to your hand. Okay. Interesting. Fighting Flame Dragon. Dragon monster and a fire warrior. Except during the damage step, quick effect, you can target a warrior fusion monster you control, equip this card from your field, or graveyard to that monster you control as an equip spell. You only use this effect once per turn. While this card is equipped to Flame Swordsman or a monster that mentions it, the equipped monster gains 700 attack and make a second attack during each battle phase. That's kind of a nutty card. That is actually kind of wild. Reinforce. I've never seen this one. Chimera Rescue. Makes it extra funny that I spent like $36 to get the Rescue Ace card just to end up pulling a bunch of Rescue Ace cards. Hell yeah, brother. What stuff can you get in this set? Rescue Ace, Altergeist, the new Flame Swordsman stuff, new Earthbound Immortal stuff, Bonfire, which is like an $80 card. I don't remember what other things there are. Altergeist Protocol, Doppel Warrior, Flame Swords Realm. Opponent cannot activate cards or effects when you normal summon a Fire Warrior monster. Fucking okay, Jesus Christ. Once per turn, you can send a monster from your hand or face the field to the graveyard, special summon a Flame Swordsman from your extra deck. This is treated as a fusion summon. When a monster declares an attack, you can target a warrior monster you control until the end of this turn. It loses exactly 1,000 attack. All the monsters you currently control gain 1,000. That's kind of wild. It's a continuous spell, but it sounds like a field spell. Don't tell Gage. Joyfan's eating crazy right now. There's a white. White! Earthbound Geoglyph. Dragon Odd Eyes. Sure, dog. I'll give you some fucking odd eyes. What are you screaming at me for? Oh. It's bedtime. Pokemon sleep. More like Pokemon sleep on this fucking dick, idiot. Oh. I don't know what else is expensive in here that's not like the Quarter Century Secret Rares. Then will Tristan fans eat well? We don't need that. We don't need that at all. They can stay away. Pend! Linewalker, Horned Saurus again. Earthbound Prison. Is this a card made for ants? This card is activated. You can target an effect monster your opponent controls. This card gains this effect. While this card is in the field zone, negate the effects of that face-up effect monster while it is on the field. During the main phase, you can normal summon an earthbound monster in addition to your normal summon set. You can only gain this effect once per turn. If this card is in your possession, it is destroyed by an opponent's card effect, and you have an earthbound monster in your group field or graveyard. It should be on your field or in your graveyard. But half your opponent's life points, and if you do, negate the effects of all face-up cards your opponent currently controls. Okay. Sure. Pend! That's a cute crow. I like it. Millennium Revelation. That's just not good. White! I agree. Ah. What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? Show me the goods. Show me the goods. Combat Wheel? It's generic. First time this card will be destroyed by opponent's card effects, such as each turn, rather. It is not destroyed. Okay. Once per turn during your opponent's battle phase, quick effect, you can discard a card. This card gains attack equal to half the total attack of all other monsters you currently control. Then place one counter on this card. For the rest of this turn, your opponent's monsters cannot target monsters for attacks except this one. If this card with the counter is destroyed by battle, destroy all monsters you control. That's fine, I guess. It's neat. Just gonna take this. Just gonna take this leave real quick. I'm just gonna slide that in there. We got one. Bonfire, add one level 4 or lower power monster from your deck to your hand. You can only activate one per turn. It's a Fire Rota. And we sure did get one. This card reserves only when Sailor Moon Lady admits to making her husband's manga for the last 8 years. It'll never happen. Yeah, the Flame Swordsman stuff works really well with Infernoble, which is crazy. Does anyone know what else in this pack is like actually insane to pull? Because I only know about Bonfire, Jet Synchron, and some of the Flame Swordsman stuff. I actually don't know what else is like super crazy. Oh, and the super short print fucking Triple Tactics Thrust, I guess. Geo-Kraken, Linewalker, Turbulence, Triangle Zero. Heard so much about this. If you control Crystal Skull, Ashoka Pillar, and Cabrera Stone, destroy all cards on the field. Also, the rest of this turn, your opponent takes any effect damage you would have taken instead. You can banish this card from your graveyard, target one each of those in your graveyard, shuffle them into the deck, then draw three cards. What is the point of these cards? This seems fucking worthless. Awful. Fucking terrible. Earthbound Greater Linewalker. They're doing too much with the fucking Earthbounds. Oh, Turbulence was the guy in that one. Alright, we have... how many is that? Five? Five on that side. Three on this side. Eight packs. I had to do the math real quick. Find a Raw for their memes. I don't even know if Raw's in this pack. If he is, then I don't fucking know. Altergeist Siliquitz. Contain. Fighting Flame Dragon. Triangle Zero. Ancient Chant. Atomic Dragon of Raw from your deck or graveyard to your hand. If you do, contribute summon a monster during your main phase this turn. In addition to your normal summon set, you only gain this effect once per turn. You can banish this card from your graveyard if you tribute summon the Winged Dragon of Raw this turn. Its original attack defense becomes the combined original attack defense of the monster tributed for its summon. You can only activate one Ancient Chant per turn. Sure. Okay. Cool. Thank you, buddy. That's great. That's neat. Really cool. It's all right. It's fine. Could have been a bonfire again, but it's okay. What's the guy's protocol? Marionetter, Ashoka Pillar. Ashoka, my penis! Ashoka, my penis! There's a chance. Linewalker, Prime Banshee, another Colorless! I'm actually happy about that, that's cool. I think Colorless is cool. So sad Ahsoka died of Legoma. Who the fuck is Ahsoka? Ahsoka Mabal. True! Dude, you got him so fucking good with that one, dude. That's crazy. Yeah, Colorless is in this. Colorless kind of sucks. Actually, let's read Colorless together as a family. It needs Rainbow, Overlord of Dark World, and two Fiend Monsters. If this card is fusion summoned, you can destroy all cards your opponent controls. Cards' original attack defense each become the number of materials used for its summon times 1,000. Once per turn, quick effect. You can target a face-up card you control, discard a card. Also, your opponent cannot target that face-up card with card effects the rest of this turn. Not that bad. He's alright. Combat Wheel. Iron Banshee, Flame Swords Realm, Supreme Rage. Is it about the Dark World Structure deck for $6 a copy and I'm looking to juice that baby up? Ooh. I thought about getting one of them. I like Dark Worlds. I don't know if I like them enough to try building them again, but I like them. Giovanni, my Pokeballs. Mario! Desynchro, Combat Wheel, Stone Sweeper, gross. The combo! Sick reprints, guys. Final three packs. Hey, you know what? I got a bonfire. That's kind of all I wanted. I'm gonna sell the shit out of that. I kind of don't need it. I don't plan on running Fire Kings anytime soon. Considering how much fucking Rescue Ace is gonna cost me, and then they're just gonna ban the Diabelle Star cards, and I'm gonna fucking break down crying. When Bonfire pays for the box. Oh, yeah, absolutely. I think Bonfire, I mean, I can check right now. Just gonna pull this out a little. TCG player. How much is Bonfire? Yu-Gi-Oh! Bonfire actually went up. Bonfire right now is a almost $100 card. So this pays for the box that I pulled it out of. It was at 120 at one point. It went down to like 80 something before. Yeah, its lowest point was like the other day. It was 84, 81, and now it's shot up to 98. So I gotta get on that. Let me close some of these other fucking tabs I have also, just in case. I should keep TCG Player open, genuinely. Oh yeah, this bitch is getting sold. I don't need that bonfire. I also hate Yu-Gi-Oh! Secondary Market. It fucking womps real bad. It is pee-pee caca. Prisoner Groundkeeper. Skeletus. Magiceptor Raccoon Bunbuku. I heard of Bunbuku's kind of cool. He has no effect up there. Do you not have a pendulum effect at all? That's insane. I've never seen that on a card. None of the Magiceptors do. Well, this shows how much I fucking give shit about Magiceptors. Stupid little bastards. Think they're fucking better than me. How do you go about selling cards? I genuinely have no idea. I think you sign up to sell on like TCG Player or one of those websites, and then like someone will contact you going, send card to here, and then you have to mail it to them. Emergency. Hell yeah. Totem pole. What the fuck? Opponent cannot target rock monsters you control with zero original attack with card effects. Once per battle, when an opponent's monster declares an attack, negate that attack. And if you do, place a counter on this card. This card has three counters into the graveyard. You have three more rock monsters in a graveyard with zero attack, different names from each other. Banish this card from your graveyard. Any effect damage your opponent takes this turn is doubled. Shit yourself. Geograsha. Yata.
Well, cool. Last hack.
I think I also have stamps somewhere. I remember having to buy them when I had to send out the thing for my court date. Dragon Darkworm, Jet Synchron, Earthbound Prison, Reinforce. All right, we got one bonfire, which is honestly better than I thought. I was expecting nothing from this at all. Sick. Happy with that. Plus the Flame Swordsman stuff. Like, I would have liked some more of the Flame Swordsman things, but pretty all right. Pretty cool. What's up, Magnetic Dragon? How we doing?
The big one.
We need SP Little Knight, Diabelle Star, Wanted. Those three, any one of those three makes this worth it. I have the one Diabelle Star that I actually have somewhere around here. Where did I put her? Is she in the box? Where's the box? Box? Box. Here she is. I have one Diabelle Star already. And two Fenrir. This is like the most effort I put into having rare cards in a deck. Only because I've already pulled them from packs, so like, why not? Like, sure, might as well go all out with that. Let's crack this fucker open. How much was this? What, this box? This box? You don't want the answer to that question. The one I bought at MagFest was like 100 something, but I think it was actually just $100, and I was like, hell yeah. This one, I had like $30 more to that, and then, you know, it might be might be correct, but we, you know, we don't talk about it. You know, it's okay. I have money. We got paid. I didn't, all my bills are paid off. I had enough to spare, and you know, everything is fine. Everything is okay. Everything is great. Everything is fine. Everything's okay. We're gonna open this little son of a bitch here first.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's about normal price. I got the, I think the last box or one of the last boxes of Agov at Magfest. Because I went back to the stalls like the next day and they were like, we are all sold out. I was like, well, I mean, at least I got one. Boxes go for about 50 to 60 over here in the UK. Fake money. Master Tao the Chanter, Watt Sink Fighting Porter, Miracle the Supreme King, Kino Baron, Shade of Peacock, TG All Clear, TG Close, don't need TGs.
TG more like pee pee, poo poo, caca. Garbaggio. Really bad. Haha.
TGs aren't like that bad. I only need to buy a box. Buying three packs at a time isn't doing it anymore. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Trust me, when you get a full box and you pull some good shit, it's like an orgasm. The best one you can have.
Escape God.
You're just breaking out, you know? Cursed Bride Doll. Cunt!
What?
Play of the Tistana, Embrace of the Tistana. I don't care about Tristana. Sweet Roommate. Card sent from the hand and or deck to the graveyard. Target a card in either graveyard, shuffle into the deck. Sure. Loka Subsara. It's a card for Visa, Star Frost. I forgot about the fucking Nouvelles, actually. People talked about them and were like, oh, the Nouvelles seem really interesting and cool. And then they stopped being talked about and cared about. I'm gonna put that Jet Synchron up there. These over. I popped off getting a Pearly. Oh yeah. Pearly's cute. Again, Mimi, if you want the other Pearly cards that I have, you can have them. I don't plan on playing Pearly. Nemorelia Repeater. Bride Doll. Litheworm. Pit Knight Philly. Cute. Wassenaire de Nouvelle. I'm just saying, she can get it. Yen the Diamond Tiger. Rose Papillon. Charv Sarga. You're just making up words. None of that's real. Guess you're never going to the Pearly Gates. Ultra Hell. Transcendosaurus X Raptor. Soul Supreme Celestial King. Starring Knight. This one looks fucked up. Or my eyes are fucked up. No, this one's just blurry. Oh wow, this one's a misprint. Like the light thing's blurry up there. The text up here, down here is all blurry, but this text is fine. Wow, that's wild. Stars align above the shrine. Sure, dude. Synchro Rumble. Alpha Summon. I don't know if that's money. It's a common, so I don't think anyone's like clamoring for that. I have a message from Mimi. I'll show you the pearlies that I have. I think I put them. Where did they go? Oh shit, actually they're out in a different box outside. I have to go grab them from there. Forgot it that I put them there.
A scapegoat.
Discordance of the Tistana, Earthbound, Servant Geogram Lina, Tarai, Mighty Striker, Realm Eulogy. Immortal Bushi mourns the mortal body. All monsters in your graveyard become warrior monsters once per turn during the end phase. Destroy all monsters you control. or you can. You can do that. I don't know why you would. I know that I got a noir. I got a bunch of happiness. I got a plump or two. I got a couple. I got some of the spells. Some of the shiny spells. Got a good amount of pearly. Discordance, Fighting Porter, Full Armored Exceed, Shino Baron Shade, Supreme King Gate Magician. This is what's wrong with fucking Yu-Gi-Oh right here. This is what's fucking wrong. Look at all of this. I'm not reading all of that shit. That means nothing to me. This may as well be in another goddamned language. What, Twinks? No, Twinks are always welcome. But when Twinks make me read, that's when I shut off my brain and tell them to die. Read at your own peril. Peacock, cock, cock, play of the Tistana, Soul of the Supreme Celestial King, Watuna. The card after this is a spell card. It's Realm Elegy. It's nothing. Startling Stare of the Snake Eyes. Kaya Prominence, the... Not a good card. Late Night Pack Opening. Yeah. Oh, how does Pendulum Fusions work? All right, so you fuse them, and then if they get destroyed, they go to the top of the extra deck, and then you can bring them back. A pendulum summoning. I don't know, that's stupid. Cunt! Serving! Yeah! Wat Tuna, Transcendosaurus Exoraptor, Wat Kyuki. Fellas, that's a shiny card that has a W at the start. Fellas, that is a shiny card with a W at the front. I got debated hard. Wings of Light. During the main phase, add a Supreme King Dragon or Supreme King Gate Pendulum Monster from your deck to your hand. Or if you control Supreme King Z Arc, you can special summon it instead. You can only activate one Wings of Light per turn. Ow. I keep hitting the wire. That is a 24 cent card. Anyway, card scanner, UFO light, invasive alien species, the immortal Bushi. That pays for the box itself. Why did you rip it? It tricked me. I thought it was a wanted. I got very excited. Also, I already have one from the last ones I pulled. I'm never gonna use that card. It's 24 cents. I who cares? That one sucks. Pee pee caca. Nemorelia Repeater, Master Tau, Pit Knight Philly, Flummer Exceed, Starry Dragon Cycle. Target a Fusion Synchro Exceed or Link Monster in the field. Return that face-up monster to the extra deck. Based on its card type, special summon an appropriate monster from either graveyard to your field. Fusion, monster with the same attribute. Synchro, monster with the lower level. Exceed, monster with the same level as its rank. Link, monster with the same type. Only activate one per turn. Okay. Close again. Card scanner.
Let's go.
Sniffle Spoils of Doom. How do you pronounce that? Celia? I guess. Ken the Warrior Dragon. That's the first Ken. Yogram Lina, Play of the Tistana, Sinful Spoils of Betrayal, Silvera.
A very pretty card. Oh, that's just a big ass wolf. That's a big wolf guy. I like that.
Startling Stare of the Snake Eyes, Rose Papillon, blah blah blah. Let's go side to side. We're like halfway through this box just about. Lightworm, Pendulum Evolution, Lila Rap. Yo, check it out, baby. This card's very funny. I like it a lot. Watkuki. Infernal Flame Banshee. I haven't seen this one. You can attach a material from this card, take a pyro monster from your deck, and either add it to your hand or send it to the graveyard. This card is banished. You control a pyro monster. You can special summon this card, and if you do, it gains attack equal to the number of your currently banished monsters times 100 until the end of this turn. Only use your effect once per turn. Okay. That's cool. Not the ultra that I would have wanted, but Angelica's Angelic Ring. Red Arrows. Eulogy. I think that's an ultra. Pretty sure that's what ultras look like. Oh, of course it is, because Bonfire is an ultra. That's what it looks like. Don't mind me, I'm stupid. Soul Supreme Celestial King, Lila Rap, Miracle the Supreme King, Tarai, Tristana, the divinity that defies darkness. This card is special summon. You can send all face down cards your opponent controls to the graveyard. You can only use this effect once per turn. Once per turn, this card has Crystal God Tristana as material. Detach a material from this card against 2000 attack until the end of your opponent's turn. This card you control is destroyed by an opponent's card while it has material. Special summon a Tristana monster from your graveyard. La-di-fucking-da. That's great for you, bitch. What does it do for me? Nothing. I gotta duck out. Oh, have a good night, Stark Maximum. Thank you for coming by. We still got a good amount of pack left. I'm hoping for at least one card that I like super need. Sars Align Above the Shrine. I like saying that. Master Tau, Scapegoat. It's Exceed the Pendulum. I got excited because it was in the spot that the good cards come in, and it was a Link monster. Exceed the Pendulum, still cool. Cool card. I have one already, but it's neat. Very nice looking. I don't actually know how good it is and how played it is compared to the original Exceed the Pendulum. I agree, she can get it. Need a little sip. Mr. Conchu, how's it going? Let me tell you guys this, because I just remembered this from earlier today. My mom messaged me when I was at work saying, don't take any more of those edibles. They're laced with fentanyl. I saw it on the TV. And I went, mother, is it the exact brand that I have? Or did you see the word edible in a story on the news and then have a panic attack? And she said it was on America's Most Wanted. A 16-year-old overdosed from an edible that was laced with fentanyl that she bought off of Snapchat. And I went, well, I mean, that means that could be fucking any kind of goddamned edible. That could be a brownie. Parents. Cursed Bride Doll, Rukilia, Ken, Tarai, Starry Dragon Cycle. I need to stop seeing that card. Fingers Soul, Snow Devil. Why? Cracker! Oh, Ritz! Boys, anything off Snapchat? That's what I'm mousing. Love the podcast? Hell yeah, love to hear it. Always happy when people say they like listening to the podcast. I think that we do a decent job with it. The Rap, Miracle Supreme King. What in the fucking lord does that say? Kabesenuth. I mean, the horses are pretty cool. He's useful. I can actually send that one to Shibuya. Shibuya could use it. in his Skull Servant deck if he decides to go with a Horus Skull Servant. I just know that the Horus cards are actually like pretty sick. Well, I caught up for the most recent episode. Yeah. Court. I'm gonna have to buy another thing to put fucking cards in that's not a tin that'll bend them, huh? This is a hell of my own making. I love rap. Pit Knight Philly. I'm just saying, she's really cute. I really like this card. I don't even know what she really does. Hold up. Special summon to a zone a link monster points to target. One monster you control 1500 less attack. This turn it can make a second attack during each battle phase. Also, if it battles opponent's monster, any battle damage it inflicts to your opponent is doubled. During the standby phase of the next turn after this card was destroyed by battle card effect instead of the graveyard, special summon it. Each effect once per turn. All right, sure. You need a binder? I do have a binder. It is full. But I also have two big, like, suitcase style boxes that are also full. So, I mean, I've got a lot of cards. Why is the card sticky? There's some questions that you probably shouldn't be asking me, you know? Snake Eye Ash! The bonfire target! What? I actually don't know how much he's going for, so I'm just going to sleeve him just in case. Just in case. I don't know how much he goes for. Let's check. Snake Eye Ash. That's the one. He is a almost $4 card. It's better than the other ones. The rest of it's all filler. It's all just... All right, how many packs do we have left? Four on this side. Four on this side. The final eight. I'm pretty sure that the last Ultra that I pulled from the pack I got, or from the box I got at MAGFest, had the Diabelle Star in it. So I have hope that I can pull something good from this box. At least we got a bonfire to sell, and that's neat. I can say that I pulled one and held one in my own two hands. Geogrim Lina. Kellia, Pit Knight Philly, Ken the Warrior Dragon.
Just get that right there. Get that right in there. And there we go. There we go. Let's just do that. That's a $140 card right there.
Actually, let's see. I see it on the side of the fucking website here. How much does this go for right now? Actually, it goes for $95 right now. That dropped pretty drastically from the last couple days where it was at $120. Hell yeah. That made it worth it. That's made the box much more worth getting. Oh, I didn't look at the rest of these. I'm sorry. How could I have forgotten? Oh, no. I'm thinking of a different one. This is Elegy and Eulogy. Box mostly paid for. Yeah, but I'm keeping this one because I need it. Squirtance of the Tistana. Wat Kyuki, Nemerlia Repeater, Master Tao. Nephil Abyss, the Ogdoadic Overlord. Sure, dog. That's great.
24 packs. 24 packs. This one feels like it had less in it, though.
But these are 9 cards per pack. How many cards are these per pack? 7 cards per pack. That's why. That's why it feels like these had more. Kind of a ripoff. Fucking Maze Millennia is like fucking almost $80 and you only get fucking 7 cards out of each pack. Kind of caca. Birthmit, the mythical king of phantom beasts. That's neat. The Birthmit stuff is actually kind of cool. It's actually somewhat playable. I'm so excited. We got a fucking bonfire and a wanted. That's sick. That fucking rips dick. Warmer Exceed, Lightworm, Moth Sync, Pendulum Evolution, Glaive Blaster. Synchro Summon. Quick effect target monster in the field, special summon from the extra deck. Banish it. Oh wait, hold on. Target a monster on the field, special summoned from the extra deck, banish it. Use this effect a number of times per turn up to the number of non-tuner synchro monsters used to synchro material for this card. You could have just said that last part. 1% if a monster is banished face up, except in the damage step target, one of them special summoned to your field, ignoring its summoning conditions. Alright, yeah, that's fine. He's cool. That was okay. The last 4. If I could get one more wanted, one more Diabelle Star, or even a Little Knight, somehow. A Little Knight would go fucking crazy, actually. Glaive Blaster's 25 cents. That sounds about right. Scapegoat. Watt Tuna. First Bride Doll. Ken. That one's crazy. That one I know is a lot of money. Imseti. Again, not the secret that I really wanted, but it's a good one. It's a good one. Alien Species Alpha Summon Klonkua. How much is Imseti? I'm pretty sure it's like 40? Glory of Horus. 66.98 actually. Jesus fucking H. I mean, shit. It's not bad. Again, not this, which I would rather have. Or another Diabelle Star, which I'd rather have. But that's good. If I don't just give it to Shibuya, then I could sell it for money. And that's good. Exoraptor, Discordance, Earthbound Servant, Watkyuki, Switch Point! Choose a monster your opponent controls, and your opponent sends either of the following to the graveyard. They choose a monster, the other monsters they control. You must control 3 or more monsters for you to activate and resolve this effect. I don't know why they did this. It makes no sense. The card's not good. The card's not good. No need for it to be there. Final 2 packs. Asset, Repeater, Full Armor Exceed, Stars Align. Happy, happy, happy. Well, we pulled like at least one of each horse, except for there's like one more. One other horse we haven't gotten. That's pretty cool. Final pack. Last pack luck. Starring Knight. Play of the Tistana, Sinful Spoils, Supreme King. It's Vanadium. Vanadium Triskuta. Trisukta. I don't know what this guy's going for. Oh, I forgot that fucking Typhon Sky Crisis is in here also. I could have had him. That would have been fucking sick. You're gonna make me hype up this dude. Scooter. 47. 47 cents. Cool. Sick guy he got there. Well, I mean, well, this was Maze stuff. I mean, are these two not bad? Not bad at all. Oh yeah. Look at those puppies. I'm trying to take a picture of them. This is not a good picture. Let's just I didn't mean to do that. I accidentally took a picture. Let's just try to get this down in there a little more. Oh yeah. Really hard to look at them without the light just kind of shining on the sleeve. I mean, hey, I got a wanted, which is all I really wanted. I pulled a bonfire, which is cool. And that guy's money. So overall, pretty decent pulls. I got this Horus guy. Two of these little Horus fellas. I'm gonna take these out of the sleeves. They're not worth shit. These guys ain't nothing. I'll just slap them back into here. And now I have to and now I gotta fucking put them all into a tin. Overall, solid. I feel better getting a bunch of bulk from all of this money instead of spending all of that money on just one card. So that was pretty sick. We fucking got him. I don't know what to do now. That's kind of all I wanted to do was pull these. I should get a picture of these cards, though. I will hold them up. There we go. Hell the fuck yeah. Well, that's honestly probably gonna do it. I mean, that's all I kind of wanted, just to do that. How long is Buns gonna be? It looks like Buns is still doing things here. I don't want to send you all the Buns. I'll do to sleep and get a good night's rest, but I'm staying up all night and therefore I have no leg to stand on. I mean, I'm going to go to sleep now. Now that I've got So, thank you all for coming out. Got a nice spread. Hey, if anyone wants to buy this bonfire, $80. Thank you all for coming here. Thank you all for hanging out. Thank you all for seeing lovely little cards. I might try to do something with those flame swordsmen. Let's go raid super butter buns. Buns is doing gaming news and chill. Talking about things going on. Going for 5 hours, which is crazy. Thank you all for coming out. Love y'all. Have a good night. See you on a stream again. That's all I got.